Creating a poll on your Facebook page is a fantastic way to connect with your existing followers and to get noticed by a new audience. However, while it's a quite straightforward process to create a poll in a Facebook group, the steps you need to follow if you want to do the same on your business page are less obvious. That's why in this video, I'm going to show you step by step how to create a poll on your Facebook page. We start with creating a poll on the phone, how you can add various media to it or limit the duration of your poll. Then we switch over to the desktop, as the way how you create a poll in your browser is slightly different. So stay tuned and watch until the end to not miss a thing. By the way, hi, I'm Sabine Beisenberger. If we haven't met yet, welcome to my YouTube channel where I share everything marketing and sometimes beyond to help you grow your coaching business with ease. And if you're already part of my community, welcome back. I'm so glad you're here. Now, without further ado, let's grab your phone and open the Facebook page app or hop over from your personal profile. Once loaded, click the publish icon. As you can see, the poll option is not listed in this preview section down here. Just click Add to your post, scroll down until the green poll icon appears, click it, and start to create your poll. Let's go with what do you really want as a question? And then let's type the two answers or options in the respective areas. Let's go with get more clients. And you can see this little number 8 over here. This actually means that you have 8 characters left for your option 1 answer. If we click into option 2, you can see that the total is 25 characters. So let's go with option 2, generate more income. You can leave your poll like this, which means it's simply a text-based poll, or you can add videos or images or a GIF or a GIF, depending on which pronunciation you prefer. To do that, simply click those little pictures over here. We want to add a GIF or a GIF. We want to go for crowd here with the first one. And for consistency purposes, we need to add obviously one to our second option as well. And here we go with a money related image. And ta-da, our poll is created. You're nearly there, but wait a bit. How can I add more answer options, you may ask? Well, for some strange reasons, Facebook is only offering us 2 options when you run an official Facebook poll on your business page using their template. Yes, 2 and no more, which doesn't really make sense to me as there are no restrictions when creating a poll in a group. I did a little research though, and there seem to be some party tools or apps out there if you want to create a more fancy poll. Having said that, I didn't test any of them, so I can't recommend one. If you decide to try one of those tools, make sure that the one you go with is approved by Facebook to avoid getting your account shut down. What you can also do is to create what I call an unofficial poll. To do that, simply create a standard post and give your audience different answer options, which they can reply to in the comment section to give their vote. You can do this with bullet points or emojis or a pre-created graphic, whatever you feel more drawn towards. By the way, I've created some Facebook tutorials here if you're interested in learning more how to leverage the Facebook social media powerhouse for your coaching business. Okay, let's go back to our poll and let's finish it so I can show you how to create one on your desktop too. Let's change the date by when the poll should end. As mine is more of an engagement poll, I want this poll never to end, so I click the clock section here, select never, and now I can add a check-in or a feeling and activity to my poll down here. So let's add a feeling, I want curious. And by the way, if you create the poll on your desktop, which I will show you in a minute, you can select additional features like photo, video, or get messages or see a preview of your poll. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Once you're happy with everything, click continue. And if you want to publish it right now, click publish. But if you want to save it as a draft or schedule it later, click the arrow here, make your selection, and once done, click done. Voila, you just created a poll on your Facebook business page via your mobile phone. Now, I know that some people think it's ridiculous to have only two answer options available when creating a poll. What do you think? Is having only two answer options sufficient? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. Over to creating a poll on the desktop. From your personal profile, go to your Facebook business page. I personally like to use the drop-down menu here. Then, in the top menu, go to Publishing Tools. Once loaded, click the plus Create button. Then, click the three little dots here and click the poll feature. Now you see the same poll template you saw on your mobile phone, just with a tad more options and settings down here. Let's replicate the poll we created on our mobile phone. Don't forget to set your poll duration. As in my case, it's more of a fun poll. I click never, add any feelings activities, get messages or check in location. And then you can here in this section preview your poll, which you couldn't do on your mobile phone, either as a desktop review or as a mobile preview. And once you're happy with both, close the window. And if you're ready, share your poll now. If you don't want to publish it right now on your Facebook business page, click this little drop-down menu here and you can either schedule it later, backdate it, or save it as a draft. You've just created a poll on your business profile via your desktop. Yes, it's a little bit more complicated to get to the poll option on your desktop as you need to use the Publishing Tools menu. But now that you know it, creating a poll should be a piece of cake for you. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends and peers. And as always, I appreciate you watching my videos. And if you want to see more from me, how about watching these videos over here? Bye for now, and I'll see you over there.